Alright, hey guys, so I thought I would make a YouTube video, finally. It's been well and truly a month now since my last one, so... yeah, so here it is. So, thought I'd give you an update. So it's coming close to an end here now. I have 25 days left here, sadly. It's kind of a strange feeling. It's somewhat hit me and somewhat not. I think most exchange students that go through this, they kind of become bipolar at this time. They know exactly what I mean. You know, some days you're excited and happy because you realize you're going to see your family and your friends in a couple of weeks, and it's just overwhelmingly exciting since you haven't seen them in a year. But it's also very, it's kind of a sad time as well because you leave your family and friends that you've made here. So it is a strange feeling. I'm not going to try to focus on that right now. I'd rather just live it up and enjoy my last couple of 3 weeks or so here. And yeah. So, that was a chair, by the way. I didn't fart. It's been up. I finished school last week. It was my last week at Sandia Prep. Didn't really feel like my last day, so I wasn't really too sad about it. I know, like I said, I don't think it's really hit me that I'm leaving so soon, so it wasn't really a sad day for me, it was just a bit of fun. I'm not taking finals, luckily. I took them last semester, but my coordinator and my teachers allowed me not to take them this semester because, you know, I could do so much more other stuff during the finals week. Since, you know, I'm leaving so soon, my grades don't count, so it's pretty pointless to take finals, so I'm really thankful for the coordinator and teacher that did that for me. And it is bloody freezing out here, so I'm going to zip up just a second. But yeah, so last week of school, and don't tell me you jammed. Don't you hate that when the jacket gets jammed and it's bloody freezing? I swear. Oh, okay. 2 weeks ago, or three now, I'm not quite sure, I'm losing track of time pretty quick. I had my last Rotary Youth Exchange weekend with my inbound friends and outbound friends. It was an amazing weekend. We went down to Roswell, the famous town for the UFO crashing. So a lot of people know Roswell for UFO and aliens and all that stuff. So it was really fun though. I got to stay with this Indian family and an outbound student, so that was really cool. And yeah, just really had an awesome time with my friends. We went down to Carlsbad Caverns, which was my second trip. I went down there in the summer originally, and so it was fun to have two trips. You know, one with my host parents, my previous host parents, and one with my exchange student friends, so it was really cool. We cleaned up the Roswell Cemetery. There was multiple there. One of them we cleaned up for a service project. And that was really cool and interesting. You know, never really cleaned up a cemetery before, so at least I can say I cleaned up a cemetery now, I guess. what else did we do? We did plenty of stuff. We were in the Christmas float parade down Main Street, downtown Roswell, whatever you want to call it. There was a lot of people that came out, so thank you to all those people that came out. It was a lot of fun. We got to hold a flag, represent our country, and we had songs from each country. I had the Six White Boomers playing from Australia for Christmas, so that was really fun. And yeah, it was sadly the last time I was going to see plenty of them, so they surprised me my last day. I'm pretty late to a lot of things, if you don't know me too well. I'm actually really bad when it comes to on time. So I was about half an hour late to my last day, because we were taking pictures with my host family, so we kind of were running late, and I arrived there, and they were holding a flag, and everyone had signed it for me, but I was just so, I hate being late, but I'm late all the time. And I kind of ran past them, ran inside with my bags, and I was like, oh, you know, like, I'm here now, I didn't even realize what they had done for me, and, you know, and then I saw that they'd signed the flag for me, and got me this awesome photo framed, you know, of our group, and they brought me some donuts and stuff. It was so much fun, and yeah, I've got such an amazing inbound group here. They really have become like family to me, all of them. Such wonderful people, such great ambassadors, and you know, they're going to great places, you know. So yeah, I'm gonna miss them a lot, but you know, we're gonna keep in contact, and hopefully Oktoberfest next year in Germany, that'd be a lot of fun. So have to start getting a job and save up for that. But yeah, we'll definitely reunite one day, our group, because we're a pretty close group. So yeah, that was my Roswell weekend, and that's about it, I think. I think that's probably about it. My host family, they own a company here, and they had like the open house Christmas party, so went to that twice, and that was fun. And actually all the employees are at our house tonight. We're having a little party, kind of end of year celebration, I guess, and a thank you party for them helping out at the Christmas party. So I should probably go soon and go downstairs and eat and socialize. But yeah, and what else? And that's pretty much it. Oh, in a couple of weeks I'm going down to up to Angel Fire, which is a little town up north from Albuquerque, and it's freezing up there, even colder than here right now, which is unbelievable. I'm gonna die probably, but they have really good snow. Oh my god, and it snowed the other night. It was either last night or the night before it snowed, so that was really fun for me to throw snowballs and stuff, so it was cool. But I'm really excited because Angel Fire has like 10 times worse snow, which is, you know, they're like, oh, snow, but I'm like, oh, snow, I'm excited. So I'm going with a couple of friends from school, so it's going to be a lot of fun. What else? That's pretty much it. Yeah, as probably everyone knows by now, it's probably worldwide headline, the Connecticut Newtown shooting at the elementary school. Absolutely just, oh, horrendous, so sad. I just couldn't even imagine what the families are going through, the victims of the family. 27 people were killed in this massacre, and I believe 18 of them were children, which is really sad. And one of the children was, a child in that shooting was actually from New Mexico. She was in Rio Rancho, so that's really sad. But yeah, absolutely devastating. Like, my heart really does go out to all the families affected by this massacre, because I just, well, somewhat I can understand a little right now. Sadly, a family member of mine was taken away from us 2 weeks ago. I'm not going to go into the details, simply because there's probably going to be a court hearing. I don't want to interfere with anything, so. But yeah, sadly, a family member was killed, and yeah, so my heart goes out to my own family, actually, back home in Australia, and I really wish you all the best, and I miss you and love you all through this very difficult time. So it's been pretty sad lately. Like they said in the news, it's just going to get worse, killing-wise, you know. Those poor children in China that were killed also, I think, on Friday, too. There was group of school kids that were killed in China recently, so that's also really sad. And then, yeah, just so much been going on. Sad, so I think I'm gonna go now because I'm absolutely dying of cold out here, and looking forward to some nice food. So it was really nice catching up with you guys. I will definitely make a video probably the week I'm leaving or so. Yeah. It's coming towards an end. I don't believe it myself, but all good things have to come to an end eventually. And yeah, I'll talk to you guys soon. Alright, catch you later. Bye.